space hotels, they're not something of science fiction anymore. I mean, you're saying in 2018?
Not really. No, not really. It's theoretically, it can be done as early as that.
Meet Robert Bigelow, a real estate developer who made his fortune building a chain of low-cost motels. Now, he's looking to grow his real estate empire off-Earth.
I mean, to imagine floating around in here, do you envision tourists also inhabiting these?
Absolutely.
He believes his company, Bigelow Aerospace, may have the solution to our space housing problem: expandable habitats.
All of this at one point, when it's first launched, is going to be compacted into a really small space and then expand into this massive structure.
Right, so it's squeezing a core, and then expansion takes place around that core, and now you have the shape of your spacecraft.
How does this thing actually expand once it's launched into space?
We just pump in gas.
What kind of gas?
Nitrogen and oxygen.
Because these habitats start out deflated and small, it makes them easier and cheaper to launch than metal structures.
The metal alternatives for the ISS have run into several billions of dollars to produce a habitat and 4 or 5 years of construction.
You can do it faster and cheaper, you say?
Absolutely.
It's not just cheaper. He says the 18-inch walls of his habitats will better protect us from space debris and radiation. Once it expands, the B330 prototype has the same volume as a small 3-bedroom house, and their largest model, the Olympus, is twice the size of the International Space Station.
What are these systems going to be used for? I mean, is this a space hotel? Is this going to be a space station?
What we're doing is trying to create a sort of generic facility, a habitat. We want to be able to entertain entities, companies, space agencies.
What you're describing sounds like a landlord.
It is. It basically is.
And the going rate to lease 110 cubic meters of volume for 60 days? $25 million. That may sound pricey, but that's still a fraction of what it costs now. And that's because there are only two habitable locations off Earth: the International Space Station and China's Space Station.
Up to now, space is characterized mostly by nations being able to only be the ones to do various kinds of things. And it's been prohibitively expensive. We're trying to attack both of those things.
Bigelow isn't the only one trying to make space more accessible. He's part of a new clan of wealthy businessmen turned space entrepreneurs. But unlike the other tech-savvy moguls, he's surprisingly old-fashioned.
Do you use a laptop?
No.
Do you use email?
No, I don't. I don't want to bother with it.
His fascination with space started as a young boy growing up in Nevada and hearing about his grandparents' encounter with a UFO.
After hearing that story a few times, I realized there was a tremendous amount of things that we didn't know.
When you're talking about things that we didn't know much about, are you talking about alien activity?
Absolutely, yes.
Do you believe in aliens?
If you really bother to do the in-depth research, you come away with unequivocally that that is the only answer for all the various kinds of events that occur to people at very close range.
And it's that belief in the impossible that drove Bigelow to pursue his design.
10, 9.
Because the technology behind his inflatables is something NASA started toying with in the 60s. They dropped the idea because the materials they were using weren't strong enough.
We're trying to size our ecosystems for 6 people as a max.
But Bigelow saw promise. He licensed the technology from NASA in the 90s and started his aerospace company.
You've sunk about $200 million of your own money into this.
Actually, 275, but who's counting?
Why sink all this money into this seemingly impossible task?
We don't think it's impossible. That's the first premise, is it? Because if we did, we wouldn't attempt it. We just think it's difficult.
This isn't just an idea. His company has already sent 2 prototypes into orbit, and they have a contract with NASA to test one of its habitats on the ISS.
We're addicted to that direction of space and doing whatever we can
to get us there.
Yeah.
And keep us there.
Right.